what your teacher is telling you, you know, it might be right. Check. Because it probably isn't.
But I'd say something that's even more fundamentally Jewish about it is that man, just from the beginning, from issue one, and this is in the first issue, used Yiddish for comedic yes. effect. The first story in the first issue of Mad, October 1952, is called Ganefs, and it's about two thieves. Now, if you know, some of you might know, that Ganefs means thieves in Yiddish, but what percentage of the audience knew that? You know what I mean? And what percentage of the audience thought this is just the mad guys being silly?
For Schlugener was just a funny word.
Right, it was a funny word. But I have a friend of mine, he was born and raised, he was born in England, raised in Canada, as, you know, as non-Jewish as you can get, didn't even know Jews growing up. In fact, I met his uncle once.
No, we can actually say quite explicitly that you see Jewishness in Chris Claremont's work because he created a character who wears a Jewish star.
John Byrne created that character, but that's okay.
Shaped a character who wears a Jewish star. Can you talk a little bit about how you see Jewishness manifesting in this generation's work, if you do at all?
Well, you're dealing now not with first generation kids by and large.
Right.
Some of us were in that generation, but it almost was an accident of the time. Both Chris and Neil have more England in their heritage than Jewish in their heritage. I knew them both for probably over 10 years before I realized they were Jewish. You'll see bits of Jewish history, bits of the Jewish monomyth come in to it, the use of the first black superhero character in the Marvel Universe, to
the hippie
work that you were talking about, the Forever People. There was a synthesis in many of these guys. Joe Simon, who was not the most extroverted person in terms of traveling around the world, but editing Sick magazine and Imitation of Mad for many, many years, keeping it culturally relevant for many years.
True.
Trying to be sympathetic to the hippies in a wonderfully strange comic he did in 1967 or 1968, Brother Power the Geek, probably the first mainstream comic. Attitude towards the establishment and society. The real contribution that Kurtzman made, and it's arguably one of